Welcome, friends. Welcome back to the kitchen. I've got another busy day up in the hangar working on Charlie Foxtrot Mike Victor uniform. And on these days, this slow cooker has become my friend. So I'm going to make another super simple slow cooker, maybe a white bean chili or a chicken chili type thing. So we're going to start it with beans. I've got two cans of beans, white beans, any kind of white beans. If you wanted to, you could use red beans. It doesn't really matter. Whatever bean you like. And today I'm using navy beans, two cans of navy beans, because that's what was in the cupboard. But I often switch them up and use different kinds all at once, because beans do have different flavors and different textures. And you mix it up and it makes it very interesting, kind of nice. Those are rinsed and drained. And I know people have some very strong feelings about rinsing and draining, or draining and rinsing, canned beans. I am not someone who has a strong opinion about that one way or the other. Sometimes I drain them and rinse them, and sometimes I just open the can and pour the whole thing in. I don't notice a difference at all. So next in is a chopped onion. That's just a white onion. Sometimes I use a red onion, depending again what I have on hand. A little bit of chopped garlic that goes in. Next up, I'm going to put in a jalapeno. Jalapenos I got at the grocery store were pretty big this time around, so I'm only going to put in one. If it was smaller, I might have put in two or three. Really up to you. Next in a little bit of salt to taste, of course. I've got some chipotle powder. I've got some cumin ground up. Next in, I have coriander and cilantro. And where we live, common English usage is coriander is the dried seed, dried chopped seed, whereas cilantro is the fresh green leaf, exactly the same plant. And they have different flavors, different properties. And if you're one of those people that can't eat the fresh green leaf because it tastes like soap, the dried seed doesn't have the same compound. And you shouldn't get that soapy flavor. It's just the way it works. Don't ask me. I'm not a chemist. I don't know exactly what the compound is, but I know that it does not exist in the seed. And I take a lot of heat in the comments section when I say coriander seed, because people say to me, well, coriander is the whole plant. Yes, but here where we live, that's how we delineate whether you want the dried seed or you want the leaf, coriander versus cilantro. Next in, I've got two of these little cans of green chilies. And if I can't find these little cans of green chilies, because I can't always get them, I'll leave them out, forget about them completely. And I might chop up some pickled jalapenos and put them in, or double up on the amount of other chilies, fresh chilies that I can get. Now, if you're worried about heat, there isn't really any heat from these. A little tiny bit right at the back of your mouth, but once it's all cooked in there, you're never going to notice it. But there is a really nice earthy flavor that I can't seem to replicate using fresh peppers, or even cooking down peppers in a pan before putting them in. I've just never been able to attain that. Next in, I've got chicken thighs. These are bone-in chicken thighs that I've peeled the skin off, because nobody wants to look at chicken skin after it's been in a slow cooker for 5 or 6 hours. It's not pretty, not pretty at all. And the final ingredient is some chicken stock. So in that goes. Just give that a little bit of a stir. Put the lid on. And I'm gonna stick that on low. I'm gonna let that go all day while I'm at the hangar working on the airplane. Now, you could do this in a Dutch oven, on the stovetop, if you're going to be home and you can watch it and you can stir it and just let it simmer away all day. Or you could put the Dutch oven in your oven at maybe 275 or 300 degrees Fahrenheit and let it go in the oven for 12 hours or all day. That way you don't have to stir it and you don't need a slow cooker. So I'll see you in a little while. Now this smells absolutely amazing. I'm going to take the chicken out. And if you're following the plane refurb, we're moving right along with that. It's going really well. So I'm pretty pleased with it. I don't mind the long days and coming home to a stew or a soup out of the crock pot. And I shouldn't even say that because this is going to be an amazing soup. So the chicken I'm going to set aside for a few minutes. I need to shred that and stick the meat back in, but I don't want to do it while it's still super hot. I'm going to take the stick blender and I'm going to blend the beans down a little bit, probably halfway, just to give a real creamy consistency to the soup. And of course, if you don't have a stick blender, you could just use a potato masher, works really well, or a fork. Don't go out of your way. You just need to mash the beans down a little bit. Even the back of a spoon would work perfectly well. Now I've got some frozen corn and I'm gonna throw that in. You don't wanna put the corn in too early. You don't wanna overcook the corn. So just at the end is when that goes in. And so I'll start shredding that chicken. All right, it just pulls apart. The chicken just pulls apart. And really what I'm looking for is just to take out the bone, just like that. And there'll be a little piece of cartilage up here at the top. It's not too hot now, I can get in there with my fingers. Get rid of the cartilage. Now, chicken goes back in. Give that a stir. And put the lid on for another 20 minutes or so. Okay, now I've got a lime that's cut in half. And I just want to juice that lime in, add a little bit of brightness and acidity. And you might not need a whole lime. This one had quite a bit of juice in it, so I'm just going to go with half a lime and see how that works out. Give it a little bit of a stir and dish it up.
Ha-ha! I heard the word dish it up. Hey, friends.
Hey, Jules.
Hey, Glen.
So, white chicken chili, white bean chili, white bean chicken stew. I mean, there's so many different things that you can call it. Yes, so I used chicken thighs, and you saw that there was no skin on them, so I pulled the skin off.
And you made yourself cracklins.
Made cracklins. And so I just sprinkled salt on these, put them on a rack in the fridge all day. And then I put them in the oven at 425 and watched them closely for about 20 minutes and made cracklin. You put a little more cilantro on top, fresh cilantro at the end. A little bit of sour cream.
That's pretty good.
Avocado, if you want to put avocado in it. And of course, the cracklins.
Anything you want with the chili. Anything you put in the chili.
Yeah.
Right. The lime is really good. I like the little, I had a little spritz of lime there.
The lime
really
at
tasty.
The end?
Mm-hmm. I might add some more.
That's really good. So, crock pot, Dutch oven, in the oven. There's so many ways that you could play with this. And there's other things that you could add to it if you wanted to. I mean, don't feel that you're beholden to this particular recipe.
I shouldn't put that back in there.
And chicken skin cracklins for the win.
Okay. For the record, not my favorite.
No, it weirds some people out. I understand that completely weirds some people out.
I just don't like the flavor. If somebody with the texture and the flavor, it's not for me.
Okay, no, it is for me. So, this is a great recipe.
It's really good with the sour cream, too.
And, you know, check out the Hangar channel because we're making real progress on the airplane.
It's very exciting.
Mm-hmm. Thanks for stopping by. See you again soon.